In my previous video, I have discussed about finding the maximum and minimum values of a function. In this video, I'll continue with the application of derivatives in finding the maximum and minimum value of a function and finding the points of maxima and minima. So first we will see what is maxima and minima. Let f be a function defined on an interval d. Then f is said to have a maximum value in D if there exists a point C1 in D such that f of C1 greater than f of x for all x belongs to D. So we have a function which is defined on an interval D. We say that f is having a maximum value in D if there is a point C in this interval D such that f of C1 is greater than f of x for all the points x in this interval D. The number f of c1 is called the maximum value of f in D, and the point c1 is called the point of maxima or maximum value of f in D. Now let us consider this curve. If we consider this curve, here it is ox, oy, and we consider this curve f of x. Here we can see that here the function f of x is defined on this interval D. This is the interval D, and here we can see that here the function attains its maximum value at this point. So if we draw a line from there to the x-axis, then here we have the point C1, and this entire length f of C1 is the maximum value of f of x. Now, similar to the maximum value of this function, we also have a minimum value which occurs at this point. So here this point is called the point of minima, and here this value is the minimum value of the function f of x. So if we consider this point C1, it is a point of maxima, and f of C1 is the maximum value of f of x. And if we consider another point, say C2, then here f of C2 is the minimum value of f of x, and we have C2 is the, it is a point of minima. Now we will see what is minima. F is said to have a minimum value in D if there exists a point C2 in D such that f of c2 less than f of x for all x belongs to D. So among all the points in D, if we have a point c2 such that f of c2 is less than all those points, then we say f of c2 is the minimum value of f. The number f of c2 is called the minimum value of f in D, and the point c2 is called the point of minima or point of minimum value of f in D. So this is with respect to maximum values, minimum values, minima and maxima. Now these are critical points. About critical points, I've already discussed in one of my previous videos. Let f be a real valued function defined in an interval D. Then a point C in D is called a critical or turning or stationary point of f, if and only if f is differentiable at x is equal to C and f dash of C equal to 0, or f is not differentiable at C. So we call a point C a critical point in this interval D if f is differentiable at this point and f dash of C equal to 0, or if f is not differentiable at C, then those points are called critical or turning or stationary points. Now we see the rules to find out the absolute maximum and minimum values on a particular interval. So to find the absolute maximum and absolute minimum values of a function f on a closed interval a comma b, the first step is we have to evaluate f of x at the critical points. So we have to find f dash of x equated to 0 and find the value of x. The next step is we have to find f of a and f of b, that is the value of the function at the endpoints a and b. After doing all these, the maximum of all these values, is the absolute maximum value of f of x, and the minimum of all these values is the absolute minimum of f of x. Now we'll continue with the problems from exercise 6.3 of chapter 6, application of derivatives, from the book Applied Mathematics class 12 by M.L. Agarwal. So here it says, find the absolute maximum and absolute minimum value of the following functions at the indicated intervals. Also find the points of absolute maxima and absolute minima. The first one is, we have to find the absolute maximum and absolute minimum value of each of these functions at the given intervals. Also, we have to find the points of absolute maxima and absolute minima. F of x is equal to x minus 1 the whole square plus 3 in closed interval minus 3 comma 1. So we have to remember the working rules and then solve the question. The first step is, we have to find the critical points. So for that, we have to find f dash of x. F dash of x is the derivative of f of x. It is nothing but 2 into x minus 1. At the critical points, we know that f dash of x equal to 0. Which implies 2 into x minus 1 equal to 0, or x is equal to 1. So we have to find f of 1 and we have to find the value of the function f at the endpoints minus 3 and minus 1. Here 1 is also an endpoint and a critical point. So we will find f of 1 and f of minus 3. So f of 1, here we have to substitute 1 in place of x in f of x. So f of 1 is 3 and f of minus 3 is minus 3 minus 1 the whole square plus 3. So it is equal to 19. So among these two, the maximum value is 19 at x is equal to minus 3 and the minimum value is 3. At x is equal to 1. Therefore, absolute maximum value equal to 19 at x is equal to and absolute minimum value equal to 3 at x is equal to 1. So these are the absolute maximum and minimum values of the functions, and these are the points of maxima and minima. Next question, f of x is equal to 2x cubed minus 15x squared plus 36x plus 1 on the closed interval 1 comma 5. So first let us find f dash of x. F dash of x is 6x squared minus 30x plus 36, or it is equal to 6 into x squared minus 5x plus 6. Now at the critical points, we have f dash of x equal to 0. It means we have 6 into x squared minus 5x plus 6 equal to 0. Here this is a quadratic equation in a x. So we can see that the roots of x are 2 and 3, because it is of the form x minus 2 into x minus 3 equal to 0. Therefore, x is equal to 2 comma 3. Now we have to find the value of the given function at the critical points, that is 2 and 3, and then at the endpoints 1 and 5. So f of 2 is equal to 2 into 2 cube is 8 minus 15 into 2 square is 4 plus 36 into 2 plus 1. So if we simplify, we get 29. Then the next critical point is 3. So it is 2 into 27 minus 15 into 9 plus 36 into 3 plus 1. So on simplifying, we get 28. Now we have to find the value of the given function at the endpoints 1 and 5. So f of 1 is, on substituting x as 1, we get 24. And f of 5 is, on substituting x as 5, we get 56. So among these, the maximum value is 56 and the minimum value is 24. Therefore, absolute maximum value equal to 56 at x is equal to 5 and absolute minimum value equal to 24 at x is equal to 1. Next question, f of x is equal to 3x raised to 4 minus 8x cube plus 12x square minus 48x plus 25 in the closed interval 0, 1. So first let us find f dash of x to find the critical points. So it is 12x cube minus 24x square plus 24x minus 48, or it is equal to 12 into x cube minus 2x square plus 2x minus 4. Now at the critical points, f dash of x equal to 0 implies the function inside the bracket is equal to 0. X cube minus 2x square plus 2x minus 4 equal to 0. Although it is a cubic equation, we can factorize it. Here x square into x minus 2 plus 2 into x minus 2 equal to 0. X square plus 2 into x minus 2 equal to 0. Or we have x is equal to 2. Here we cannot take x square plus 2 equal to 0 because we will not get real roots. We will get x square equal to minus 2 or x is equal to plus or minus under root minus 2, which is not required. So here we will take x is equal to 2. Now we have to find the value of f at the critical point and at the end points. So f of 2 is equal to 3 into 2 raised to 4 is 16 minus 8 into 2 cube is 8 plus 12 into 2 square is 4 minus 48 into 2 plus 25. So when we simplify, we get minus 39. Then at the end points, f of 0 equal to 25 and f of 3 is equal to 3 into 81 minus 8 into 27 plus 12 into 3 square is 9 minus 48 into 3 plus 25. So on simplifying, we get 16. So among these, the maximum value is 25 at x is equal to 0 and the minimum value is minus 39 at x is equal to 2. Therefore, absolute maximum value of f of x equal to 25 at x is equal to 0 and absolute minimum value of f of x is minus 39 at x is equal to 2. Next question, prove that the function f of x is equal to x cube plus x square plus x plus 1 does not have maxima or minima. So here we have to show that this function does not have a maxima or minima. So to find maxima or minima, the first step we do is we find f dash of x and find the critical points. So it is given f of x is equal to x cube plus x square plus 1. So from this, f dash of x is equal to 3x square plus 2x plus 1. Now, at the critical points, f dash of x equal to 0 implies 3x square plus 2x plus 1 equal to 0. Here, when we consider this equation, it is not easy to solve it directly. So in our earlier classes, we used to find the discriminant and then find the roots of this equation. The discriminant is given by d is equal to b square minus 4ac. Here b is 2, a is 3 and c is 1. So for an equation to have real roots, we should have d greater than or equal to 0. So here if we see, b square is 2 square minus 4, a is 3, c is 1. So this is 4 minus 12, it is minus 8 less than 0. Since here d is less than 0, here this equation does not have real roots. Therefore, this function does not have a maxima or a minima. Therefore, f of x, here we can write no real roots. Therefore, f of x does not have maxima or minima. I hope this video was useful for you. In my next video, I'll start with local maxima, local minima. Thank you for watching.